Hi friends, Radhika Ravi Kumar here. So welcome back. Now let us continue with the expression transformation that we had left. Already we had given some conditions for employee ID, age, gender, and we had to create it for age. Now again, in the same way, just create a new port here in age, and give a name for your port. It's like age. Okay. Underscore age, and it's going to be an integer because it's an age, and uncheck here. Then after this, just give the condition here. Here my condition is in the same way how we created for gender. Just say if, go to the port, here you'll be having the age column. If age is less than 14, then I need to say it as young, okay, or else I'll create another if condition. If age is greater, age is greater than 14, and this is the logical operator and, okay, just say and if again age is less than 18, then I need to give the output as adolescent, or else if both condition is like false, then I need to say adult. Okay, so this is my formula. So here you can see I'm using the logical operator. You can, and is nothing but where even this condition, the age, this and this one both should be true in order to, like, the age should be, you know, should be greater than 14, and as well as it should be less than 18. So when it falls between 15 to 17, then only this adolescent will get displayed in the table, or else it will be an adult. Hope people know regarding the logical operators like and, or, not, and all. So this is the same condition how we created for gender. So just validate this and say okay. So now our ports and all are created. So let me link this with the target. So here we had created employee ID. So now what we'll do is we will just make use of a filter, and we'll filter out the employee ID where it is 999. Hope you people have seen the previous tutorial where we had given a condition if the employee ID is null, then we need to specify it as 999 or else direct employee number. So if you haven't watched it, then just go back, watch the previous tutorial, and then continue with this. So now let me make use of the filter transformation. Here you can see the filter transformation. Just click on that here and select all and drag it to the filter. So now double click on the filter, and here you need to give the filter condition. You just double click on the filter, then in the properties you can see this filter condition. Here in the filter condition, I'm just going to give the condition as where this employee ID should not be equal to, you can see this not be equal to 999. Okay, so what happens is wherever the employee ID is 9999, those things, like those records, will be blocked and it will not go further to the target. Only the employee ID which is like having a valid employee ID, then those things, only those records are only like moved forward to the stage employees table. So this is how we can use your filter transformation. So here let me link the filter to the stage employees. So just employee number to ID, then the full name to names, then gender to the, here the employee gender, then age to the एज ग्रुप, सेव दी मैपिंग, एंड या द मैपिंग इज़ वैलिड. नाउ लेट अस रन दिस मैपिंग एंड सी हाउ द आउटपुट इज. We already created the session and all. So just refresh this. Just right click and refresh mapping. Save it. And start task. You can see it's running. And yeah, it got succeeded. So let me go to the SQL developer. So here. Again, run this query. You can there was some error, I guess. Okay, we'll just check what is the error in the next tutorial. So this is how you need to create the these formulas and all inside the expression. How, and I hope you have got to know how to you make use of this filter, where the filter will just filter the records based on the condition, and only the condition which is true, only those records will be moved on to the target, and the remaining will be blocked. So hope you have understood this tutorial. We'll see the error and we'll run the mapping properly in the next tutorial then. And thank you very much for watching.